Hola amigos, pues estamos en FanFest 2018 con un invitadazo de honor. Él es Rod Ferguson, él es el encargado de que Gears of War sea lo que es a nivel mundial, en México, en toda Latinoamérica. Bueno, Rod, the legend, the man, Rod Ferguson, how are you, Rod?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm really fine. Good. Thanks for being here with us.
Oh, I'm happy to be.
I know that it's your fourth time coming here to Mexico.
Right. Yeah, I've come for, first time was at EGS, and then I've come for a couple of Gears events where we had like crazy broken down buildings and, you know, paintball and stuff. And you can hear the energy behind us. Like, coming to FanFest is amazing. I just love coming to Mexico. They're like the most passionate fans for Gears of War, and I love that.
But you're like a Mexican expert. Yeah, like you've come so many times, you know everything about it, right?
Well, what's funny is I know our hotel really well. Everybody was at our hotel last night for dinner, and I'm telling everybody what to order and what to drink because I know that really, really well. So, yeah.
That's what we know. So I want to ask you a few questions about that. Like, you as a Mexican expert. Like,
I'm not a Mexican expert just because I've been here a couple times.
No, I know. But, we know you love margaritas.
I do, very much. Yeah.
So, what can you tell us about, like, your favorite type of tacos?
El Pastor.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm a big pineapple guy. Like, I'm the weirdo that likes pineapple on my pizza back in Canada.
Okay.
And so El Pastor is, like, absolutely the best taco.
And what about the Mexican pro players of Gears of War? You have any favorite?
I'm more about the teams, you know, like, I'm really excited for today. We have that esports showcase today with the LATAM Kings and Fire and Ice, and it's just been amazing to watch the skills continue to grow in the professional arena. And you can see, like, in all of our pro circuit events where the Latin American teams are placing higher and higher and higher every time. And so I'm impressed and excited about the talent that's here.
Yeah, a lot of talent, definitely in Mexico. And how important is that talent, that Gears of War pro players, Mexican, Latin American, for the community of Gears of War?
It's hugely important. You know, we want to, like, Gears is global, and we want to have talent from all around the world. Mm-hmm. And I was saying as part of the opening night is that, you know, the Latin American players, they play the most Gears, more than anybody else. And they're actually the most skilled players. When you look at, like, kill-death ratios and stuff like that, Latin American players are amongst the best players in the world. Mm-hmm. And so having them represented with great professional teams and are showing up on the world stage and showing, like, that's sort of how global Gears of War is in esports. Like, we just did an event in San Diego. Like, it's been 2 years after Gears 4 is released, and San Diego was our biggest esports event. And we've got another esports event coming to Mexico in February. We think it's going to be even bigger. So the fact that it's been like 2 years after launch and we're still having our biggest esports events is amazing. And a lot of it has to do with the energy and passion that's here in Latin America.
Yeah, definitely. Good characteristics about the Latin American people, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, you can see it in the broadcast yesterday. It was crazy. And I mean, that's one of the fun things about coming. Like, I wish I could bring my whole team down and experience the energy of the fans and their passion and their love for the game and the franchise, and that's why I love coming. It's kind of like whenever you're feeling a little bit, oh, it's hard work and you're tired, and you come and you get to meet all the people who love your game and it means something to them. It just fills you back up with energy, and you want to go back excited and bring that back with you.
Definitely. Talking about the fans, like, you are a fan of video games, we know that, but what else are you a fan of? Besides Mexico, also.
Besides Mexico and video games? Well, those are type two top things right there. I don't know, movies, music. I like poker is a hobby that I like to play in. So I don't know. That's one of the things about, I've been very fortunate about getting to work in what I consider to be my hobby. You know, like they say that do the thing you love, and and that's video games for me. Is like I work on video games all day, and then I go home and I play video games. You know, and so I have the benefit of my kids are all pretty older now, and so I can play a lot more. And so that's kind of what I do is I play it because it's partly just for fun, but it's partly research too, to see what the industry's doing, see what's new, what's innovative, and just understand kind of where the industry's going.
Cool. And what's the craziest thing you've done as a fan? It could be from the video game world or anything else.
The craziest thing I've done as a fan. I don't know if I'd have a crazy thing. Like, I mean, once you have a once you have kids, you sort of turn down the crazy. Yeah. You know, like before I had kids, I was married, but before we had kids, I did like, I jumped out of an airplane and that kind of stuff where you just go,
wow.
Like, you know, and so there's things like that you do. You sort of, you feel like it's a life thing you want to do. But once you start having kids, you kind of go like, you know what? I'm not going to take that risk anymore. I'm not going to slow that down. Yeah. But like I said, now that my kids are, you know, pretty much grown, like then maybe I'll get back into doing some other riskier stuff. But
okay. Yeah. And you talked before about the Gears Pro Circuit that will happen in Mexico in February, right?
Right, February 1st to the 3rd, yeah.
What can the fans expect about that?
Oh, it's just going to be insane. It's going to be like, you know, the last time we were in Mexico, it sold out with teams, like over 100 teams, you know, because we do this, we do an open, so that means that people can come and play and earn their way in. They don't have to be a pro team right away. Mm-hmm. And so you get a lot of fans, and what's great is you get so much participation from the fans to come and watch. So there's a lot of energy in the room. You got 100 teams playing, you know, with for a big prize pool. And it's just, I just love watching the caliber and the skill that comes with that. And so it's going to be fantastic. I mean, the energy you saw yesterday on the broadcast is the kind of energy you'll see at the esports event.
Yeah, that would be amazing to watch, definitely. Mm-hmm. And finally, well, Rod, you have a lot of fans here in Mexico and everywhere in the world. And what would be the message that you could give to them?
Well, I mean, the fans that are in Mexico, I want you to come down today because we're doing a lot of stuff with Gears. We've got the esports event that we're about mm-hmm. to do. We've got a signing and we've got our panel. But I mean, in general, just I want to say thank you. Like the thing is that what we do when we work on the game and, you know, it's long nights and it's a lot of hard work, but it's because of the fans and their passion for the game and the franchise. And, you know, I hear all these stories about bringing people together and keeping families together and playing with, you know, people from a long distance and keeps them connected and what it means to them and the stories. And that just, like, that means so much. So, like, we wouldn't have the ability to make the games we make if it wasn't for the fans like you. So just want to say thank you to all the fans for playing and for caring.
Well, thank you for being here, for being so honest, so grateful with all of us. And we're so happy to have you here.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Bueno, amigos, ya saben, seguimos aquí en FanFest con muchos invitadazos. Síganos en todas nuestras redes sociales.